a school principal calls the cops, refers to the children as ghetto, Section 8, and everything else.
We didn't even do nothing, so we're recording you right now. That you know that's harassment, right?
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. It's harassment. You're a grown-ass man. We're minors, though.
Actually, I'm the board director here.
We're minors. We're minors.
Officer,
so how you like it in your face?
Three Section 8 people here.
How you like it in your face?
Ghetto girls.
How you like it in your face?
Look at this.
No, you're grown. Like, this is a grown man, right?
Yep.
You're
grown.
There you
go, right here.
You're grown, so I'm recording you, too.
Look at this, right here.
Yes.
Let's do this. Let's put the picture up full mask. We are going to highlight this directly. You're looking at Brejane Lewis on the left, Kyra Scrub on the right. They say they were racially profiled in a gated community in Fresno, California. Let me give you the background. A white male in Fresno reportedly called 911 after a verbal confrontation with three teenage black girls inside a gated community. That's according to ABC 7 News. Okay. Fred Veenendaal, a principal at Sunnyside High School in Fresno, said he was calling the police on April 16th following the confrontation. 17-year-old Kyra Scrub, 17-year-old Brejane Lewis, and a friend as they cut through the neighborhood on their way to the store. The girls began recording the principal as he made a phone call, and one of the teens is heard saying that he was harassing them. We didn't even do nothing. So we recording you right now. You know, that's harassment, right? After the principal responded by saying, no, it's not. He is heard calling the three teenagers ghetto. Officers, you got three girls here, he said. Three Section 8 people here, ghetto girls. The principal also held up his phone as if he was also recording the three teenagers. Let me stop right here. It's one thing to call law enforcement because you think somebody is a nuisance. Okay? Remember, you're inviting a gun to a situation where a gun is not required. It's already extreme. And then in the process of you doing this, you decide to refer to children as Section 8 and ghetto, which, by the way, informs us of your bias, informs the world. You are in a position of ultimate public trust as a principal, you are to govern the administrative processes of these children or children at large. I have more information, more background. This high school principal is also heard telling the teens that he is on the gated community's board of directors. Kyra's mom told the outlet that her daughter and her friends, they take a shortcut through the gated community because it cuts 10 minutes off their walk to the store. She added that the teens have access there, have access because they have a friend living in the gated community. Kyra told the outlet that the principal was being racist for no reason. You didn't have to do all that. You didn't have to racial profile for no reason, she said. I feel so bad because, like, as a black woman, I should be able to walk, you know, and do just walk peacefully without, you know, people being racist for no reason. And she is absolutely correct. He's an adult. He's an adult who decided to show his racism because he did not like something. He was uncomfortable with black children walking. Not bothering him, not doing anything against him or his property, just walking. There's more. Why would you even say some stuff like that? We're minors, added Brejane. I hope he gets fired. He gotta go. The girl said that the police never showed up and it's unclear if the principal actually called the authorities. The teens learned that the principal was at a high school after posting the video on TikTok. So they had no idea who this guy was until they exposed him, right? There's more. Fresno Unified, there it is, said they are investigating the incident. Quote, we are aware of the video circulating and the district started an investigation into the matter early Monday. The labels used in the video do not align with the high standards we have for our Fresno Unified leaders and staff. Read the statement. We want to assure our families that have that having respectful, inclusive, and loving adults serving in our school is of the utmost importance to Sunnyside and our district as a whole. The principal is currently on paid administrative leave while the school district investigates. That's according to the spokesperson, Nikki Henry. So these young children, these black girls, called for the firing of this principal. I think they are being appropriate in their request. And I will say, young ladies, I do believe you will get the request you have proclaimed. Okay? Once again, position of public trust, high public trust. There's a high bar, high standard that must be recognized and applied. We do not play with our children and their safety. If a principal has these deeply rooted beliefs, just by calling the police or allegedly calling the police on black teenage girls, imagine what he believes and how he treats children that may not look like him or his children. All right. David, thoughts on this?
Well, I was glad that the school district put out that statement saying that he has been on administrative leave. But there was something about that statement that also bothered me. They said it was his labels that were the problem. It wasn't just his labels. It was his action. It was his racist beliefs that were so evident. To have an educator who's got that, that is so frustrating. And the other thing about it is I can remember somebody else who used to cut through the backyard of a really nice house on the way to elementary school 40 some years ago. That was me. And you know what? My house wasn't as nice as the street that I was cutting through. I suppose if somebody had complained to me, sure, I would have changed my route. But you would expect that if somebody is angry that somebody is using your neighborhood as a cut through, you approach them. And you have the decency and respect to that person to say, look, I'd rather you not cut through here or stay on this, whatever it is. But to just sort of fly off the handle and to then call police and then to use, you know, show your sort of racism is outrageous. I hope that principal, vice principal, whatever he is, I hope he never gets another job in teaching again.
There you go. Every child, including when we were children, we cut through communities or sometimes a parking lot, whatever it may be. We wanted to shorten the route. We walked everywhere.